This week, through the Black Vault website, the CIA revealed 713 documents about UFOs. Rumor has it that they did this because of a clause that was in a bill that was recently signed by Congress stating that the government had to reveal everything that it knew about UFOs within the next 160 days. Supposedly, instead of waiting these 180 days, the CIA decided to release these documents early. However, I personally think that there's more to come because the Pentagon still has to brief Congress in the coming months. This will be the first episode in a series that I'm planning on doing, so if you'd like to stay updated, hit that subscribe button, and if you'd like to make sure that you don't miss any of these videos, tap that notification bell. I'm going to go through the papers one by one so that you don't have to, but if you are interested in reading the papers yourself, I do have a link to them in the description. The first paper slash letter slash report, written in April 1976, talks about a group of redacted people who are looking into a redacted subject within a UFO research program. At their request, a redacted doctor says that he'll look into this matter personally. The biggest takeaway from this particular report is that the government is studying UFO phenomena, even though they continually deny it, including within this report where they simultaneously admit to it. This report was written in June 1976 and was pretty useless because most of it was redacted. We can only assume that the new developments that this person is asking for have to do with UFOs, but we don't actually know because it's redacted. This one was written in April 1976 again, and it's basically useless. It just says that they want everything to stay classified, and it is mostly redacted again. In this paper, someone's asking for progress on what I assume is the UFO program, because again, redacted. This paper also mentions the name Wright Field, which I googled, and it actually refers to Wilbur Wright Field, which was a military installation and Air Force field used in World War I, a pilot, mechanic, and armored training facility, and under different designations, conducted United States Army Air Corps and Air Force's flight testing. Okay, y'all, this is where it starts to get juicy. This report is from March, I'm assuming 1976, but honestly, I have no idea. To start, the author of this report talks about how someone named Davidson wrote him a letter. There seems to be some sort of tape involved, and Davidson wants to know if Attic Cross Attic, Wright Field, has analyzed it. The author of the report says to lie to Davidson about the tape, telling him that it's been forwarded to the proper authorities and that they have no further information on it. But my guy Davidson is persistent. He politely requests to be directed to the correct authorities, keeping his cool and being super nice and polite about it, and I am here for it. The author of this report then tells Davidson that he understands that the proper contact for flying saucers are the Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, which Google told me is located in Dayton, Ohio. And these fools, oh, these fools, they try to stall him. Davidson is the subject of this report as well, because apparently the report writer had to contact a Colonel Bayard or Colonel Dayard about this whole Davidson situation because he would not say no. And apparently Colonel Bayard also thinks that Davidson will continue to persist. Okay guys, this is where the paper starts getting really, really interesting because we got full names. You heard me right, we have Dr. Leon Davidson, people, a full entire name, who I googled, and he is actually one of the guys that worked on the atomic bomb. Turns out Dr. Davidson is on this report writer's backs, so we are about to get some office drama. And my guy, Dr. Leon Davidson, wants a verbatim translation of a message from space, as well as the place from which it originated, the source, the transmitter, whatever you want to call it. And he is out for blood. He will not take no for an answer. We also have the name of another person mentioned, Wallace E. Elwood, because apparently in August 1957, Elwood told Davidson that the message was in identifiable Morse code and delivered from a US licensed radio station. Apparently Wallace gave Davidson this message to satisfy his need for a verbatim translation. But the plot thickens, people. Davidson then goes and accuses the Air Force of hiding information from him about flying saucers. And the dude is right! The author of this paper even goes so far as to say that Davidson is no fool and that Attic, or Attic, I don't really know if that's a person or a thing, is treating him as one if they think that he can be satisfied with a sop. With a sop! Such as Captain Elwood. So aside from the very tasteful drama, there are a few things that I think you can take away from this report. The first is that the doctor mentioned in the first report must be Dr. Davidson, or at least I'm assuming he's Dr. Davidson, and then they just gave up on redacting his name. Either that or it was another doctor. We, again, won't really know because it's redacted. But the point is, he's been trying to get this information for a long time now. He is the main character of this movie. We like him because he's trying to expose the government. Captain Wallace W. Elwood, aka the Sop, aka the Liar, is the antagonist. We do not like him, but we do know that he is just doing his job, which is to keep secrets, so maybe we'll give him a redemption arc later, we'll find out. But right now, we hate him and he sucks. I also did a quick Google search for Captain Wallace W. Elwood on Google, but unfortunately I did not find anything. So again, if you're watching this and you're a better detective than me, let me know in the comments. And we're in luck, people, because this next paper continues the legacy, continues the saga of Dr. Leon Davidson. But before we keep going, please hit that subscribe button if you're enjoying this video, and if you would like to see more in this series, please hit that like button to let me know. Okay, so apparently Dr. D is writing an article for a space magazine, and he wants the translation of the space message as well as the place that it was emitted from in order to prove that it was a hoax. Or he wants permission to publish the papers between himself and Attic Attic, between himself and the writer of this report, as well as between himself and the government, to prove that the government has been avoiding him and his inquiries for an entire year. That is like asking your boss a question and then having them avoid you for an entire year just so that they don't have to answer it. As a result of him being like, give me what I want now or I'm gonna publish all this stuff, a redacted person told Davidson that he would communicate with him shortly, supplying the information he requested if possible, or explaining that nothing further could be done, aka stopping him in his tracks. So my bet is on Davidson getting blocked, but the author of this paper ended it by saying, please do not let us down in our agreement to communicate with him. We are committed. Personally, I think it's because maybe they feel like they owe him for the atomic bomb, assuming again that that is this Davidson, but maybe there's another reason that we'll find out as we keep reading these papers. Is there blackmail? Is there a conspiracy happening? Or maybe Davidson is indispensable for another reason. I would really like to thank you guys for all of your support these last few months. My channel has been popping off. It's growing like crazy. I'm so excited right now. It makes me so happy, and I could not have done this without you guys. You guys are literally the reason that this channel runs. I make all this content for you, so if there's anything that you want to see, please let me know, and I am happy to make it for you. By the way, I am planning on doing a Q&A video for the 1,000 subscribers special, so if there's anything that you'd like to ask me about me or just literally about anything, feel free to drop questions in the comments of this video or any videos leading up to that, and I'll make sure to add them to my list of things to answer during the Q&A. Thanks for watching and stay freaky 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 fucking fresh. Word.